Our final panel of the afternoon, morning, is the Growth, Momentum, and Impact Business of Travel, Sports, Events, and Tourism panel. I'm excited about this one. You'll get a lot of really good information that I think you'll probably want to write down for this one. We're going to welcome back Mark O'Brien, president of Lake Sports. We're also going to welcome in Mark Jaronski, the head of Georgia Tourism. Hello, everybody.
Hi there. Great job today.
Thank you. I appreciate that. Mark, I'll start with you. There's two Marks up here.
That's right.
Great. You guys planned this.
Now it'll be so easy for you.
Mark A, Mark B. No. Mark, I'm going to start with you. Similar to Markeisha, you started and took over this job at probably the most unideal time ever, right at the height of COVID. I mean, what were the challenges with that, especially when you're dealing with Georgia tourism?
Yeah, I hear that a lot. But for me, it was actually a huge advantage. So I've been in tourism my whole career. And having the honor of this role, working under Governor Kemp's leadership, representing the great state of Georgia, not only here at home, but nationally and internationally, you're on the road quite a bit, and you get to participate in events like this. But when our tourism industry was shut down, and it was referenced earlier, right, I think it happened in the March timeframe, I started the role in July. It gave me the opportunity to really understand the team, first and foremost, right? This is a sports-oriented discussion. And organizationally, how many of us use the term team to talk about the folks that work for us, our staffs and our employees? I was a youth athlete myself growing up. I was a sports editor in my college paper. I got my job at Disney largely because of my sports experience. And that's where I started my career. But having the opportunity to really kind of start at home with the team, with the product, with our leadership, with Georgia Economic Development. I'd never worked for state government before. That is a journey in and of itself. Was an advantage. So the tourism piece was easy. Once Governor Kemp reopened the state, which was very quick and very smart in hindsight, he took a lot of flack for it, but it really gave us a huge advantage over our competitors in our tourism space. I get the question a lot, but it was a blessing actually to start a tourism job during a shutdown period.
That's actually good. I didn't think you were going to go there, so I'm glad that you did. And kind of going off of that a little bit, obviously you saw the ups and downs of tourism naturally because of the shutdown and then the reopening. But how have you seen it evolve, especially when it comes to sports in this state? We've been talking all day about this is a booming economic system for sports right now. How have you seen it evolve?
It's interesting. So from a sports perspective, as it relates to sports, travel, and youth sports in particular, you really saw how recession-proof, and I think it's a good point in time to talk about this, right? Because everyone, all the national forecasters are forecasting, or economists are forecasting recession for next year, correct? We've seen it before. I saw it when I was at Disney. Youth sports is recession-proof, and youth sports travel is recession-proof, right? While people will put off the leisure vacation, business travel stopped and still hasn't really restarted to the extent that it was in 2019. People, the last thing they will not do is come see their child play in a regional or national competition. They're going to make time for it. They're going to find the money for it, and they're going to do it. And how many of us in this room are the parent of a child who competes? It goes beyond the rational decision making of can I afford this or not, right? And it tugs at that emotion, and you will find a way to get to. I don't think I've ever missed I've missed some games here and there because of my job. I've never, it's the other thing that's interesting about sports, right? And the intersection between sports and travel is the event that's at LakePoint if you're coming from out of state or from across the country, you know that in advance. You can plan for it. You can put it on your calendar. It's not just, who's the club team playing on Saturday? Is it home or it's away? Oh gosh, I don't know if I can make that one. But when it's on the calendar, not only can the parent plan for it, can they find the money for it? Can they make sure that they're not distracted by their job or another responsibility? But it also obviously is a moment in that child's childhood, in that family's bank of memories. It touches to the core of what travel and tourism is all about.
Which also certainly helps LakePoint, I would imagine. Mark, I know that earlier you had mentioned both inflation and labor issues, because those are two things that we're all dealing with. And as it pertains to LakePoint, what have been those challenges and what are you seeing with those two categories there?
Yeah, I think we talked about the challenges earlier, and I think there's always challenges in business, in whatever business you might be in. So at our core, it's how do we shift and reimagine our business? And it really starts with our mission, vision, purpose, and values as an organization, and being values driven. So whether it's labor challenges, how do you create a culture that's really values based and really focuses on our team members? We have a mantra around one team, one goal, and that goal is excellence in everything that we do, which then, as you talk about inflation, as you talk about accessibility, and some of the points that Mark was making, we want to make sure when they make that decision to come to LakePoint as the premier travel and youth sports destination in the country, that they're going to have a great experience, and that we're going to do everything we can, not only inside the lines, but outside the lines, to really overemphasize that great experience that we aspire to have built on excellence. So we focus on the five S's: safety, sight, sound, smell, service. And we really focus on the guest experience at every touch point, even before they get here. So as Mark noted, when they're planning, we've got first communications that go out, and we engage them in a way that hopefully provides them with a better on-site experience. But in this day and age with technology, what's that off-site experience as well, whether that's live streaming or our other parts of our tech stack that can really enable a quality experience? Because in inflationary times, maybe not everybody from the family can make the trip. So how do we create access points? We talked about accessibility earlier. How do we create those access points and really focus on the guest experience?
So are you keeping those things in mind? I mean, you just mentioned the fact that sometimes, especially in inflationary times, not everyone in the family can make it. I know that you've talked about today, a big thing at LakePoint is accessibility and video. I mean, we're streaming right now to the University of Georgia. Is that one of the things that you keep in mind when we're talking about inflation, is trying to appeal to the whole family and still make LakePoint accessible?
Absolutely. I mean, I think we have to reimagine every touch point, and we have to look at it by sport, by event, by venue, and continue to challenge ourselves to create the best possible experience so that we maintain our position in the travel sports industry and continue to lead. And in even hosting events like this, enable us to engage with business partners, engage with the audience, the people that live in this space each and every day, to provide, opportunities for us to collaborate and really focus again on that guest experience and how we can improve it.
So Mark, you mentioned Disney off the top. You had extensive time with Disney and a lot of experience there. What is your initial impressions on the LakePoint campus, and especially when it comes to travel and youth sports, what are your impressions of it?
Great question. So right off the top, incredible. I remember coming here, I moved my family to Georgia, not for a job, but for a quality of life. We have four children, we wanted them to raise them in a small town with four seasons and a great school, and we found that in the Lake Oconee area. We moved here 6 years ago, and my older daughter is a competitive cheerleader, and she came to an event right in this very building, probably a year or two after it opened, and I was blown away, and I was asking the attendees who were working, the staff that was working the event, tell me more about this place. It was the first facility I had seen outside of, we called it Disney's Wild World of Sports, it's now ESPN Wild World of Sports at the Walt Disney World Complex, and I was I was a part of that business at its launch. I was part of the marketing department, but helped them do some leisure marketing, not necessarily the focused youth sports or group marketing, but some consumer marketing. And really, this was the first I had seen since then, and I've been back many times, and particularly in the last 2 years that I've been in this role, I've had the good fortune of working in and around Mark and his team. And I will tell you, in this role, you get around the state quite a bit, and I've seen many travel and tourism organizations from the mountains to the coast and in between and all across Atlanta, and five S's that Mark talked about. At Disney, there were four keys to the kingdom, if you will, and that they operationalized the guest experience around. And it couldn't be more similar. And I will tell you, I don't see that across the state of Georgia outside of this business. And I'm sure we have some resort properties. I'm sure we have some attraction properties in and around Atlanta that have something similar. But this is as Disney-esque of an operation as I've seen in the state of Georgia. And you could tell. You could tell by the guest experience when you walk through this baseball complex and you see the families and you see the competitors and you see the number of athletes and the quality of events that are attracted to this. And that only speaks well for the state of Georgia. I mean, from a state perspective, much like any other business, it's the management of a variety of assets. And we have great assets in the state of Georgia, from an Atlantic coastline to a mountain range, the Appalachian Blue Ridge Mountains, a great city, a great airport. We have more diverse tourism products than many states do. And under the leadership of Governor Kemp, we've actually been able to grow market share in the last 2 years in the pandemic, because we were open and we were operating and marketing and welcoming visitors when many states weren't. But not to be lost in all of the assets that we have across the state is absolutely the premier youth sports destination in the country.
Which is LakePoint. That's got to give you, I don't know, it's got to make you excited, right?
Well, and thank you.
We already know these things.
We didn't rehearse that, so thank you, Mark. But full credit to the team that makes that happen. And that's why we're a values-based organization. And we're not perfect by any means. We're just like any other organization that has challenges. But, full credit, it always starts with people, our team members, planning, and then ultimately execution and adjusting. So full credit to our team, but thank you for those kind words.
Mark, what gives you optimism? We've talked about the challenges throughout the day, but what gives you optimism about the year ahead when it comes to travel and youth sports?
Yeah, I think there's actually a slide we have from Sports ETA. They did a great state of the industry report, and it speaks to how much tourism has come back since COVID. So these are national numbers, but you'll see the big jump. And as Mark noted, knock on wood, I'm hoping he's 100% right that, it's particularly in inflationary times, but we have seen from consumer behavior that, this business, travel and youth sports, is very resilient. It has staying power. Abe from Sports Business Journal talked about it earlier. The consumer behavior we see, the data that we have indicates that, families are committed to seeing their young athletes play against the best competition, especially as they have aspirations to get to the next level. And I think we'll see continued growth. We already bounced back to nearly 2019 levels, and we anticipate that to continue as the rest of the country is now really back to business. And we're going to continue to try to push forward with that as we look to drive continued economic impact for our state.
And speaking of economic impact, how specifically does LakePoint contribute to the state economy?
That's a great question. The most recent data we have, and so this is this would be pre-COVID, but we historically have driven about $100 million of economic impact for the state, certainly across Bartow County, but the six surrounding counties that we're in close proximity to. We work with nearly 100 hotels during our peak season. So we're driving a lot of tax revenue through hotels, restaurants, retail, with the types of events that we have going on, where we're sold out, you know, nearly 50 out of 52 weekends, this campus has a lot going on. And then there's opportunities for us to really generate new revenue streams midweek, aligned to sports, but also complementary to the sports industry.
Mark, he just gave you some numbers, obviously. He pinpointed how many millions of dollars that they're bringing in to help the state economy. How specifically, clearly that kind of answers the question, but how can LakePoint really contribute to the state economy, and how is youth and travel sports being able to do that?
Sure. Keep doing what they're doing. Right? So tourism as an industry is second largest industry in this state. You know, and if you're in the sports business, you can relate to this. Oftentimes I'm introduced within my peer set at economic development, and you know, other peers of mine lead other industries, whether it's manufacturing or agribusiness or film. And then they get to the tourism guy and they say, and they get introduced, they say, oh, tourism, that must be fun. Right? You hear that in sports too, right? And I tell you, sports is, I think, a great model for the tourism industry in that, as was demonstrated today on all of the panel discussions, sports has achieved that level of reputation and recognition as a true business. And I think tourism still struggles from that perspective. But long story short, in answering your question, as a tourism industry, we generate last year and in for the fiscal year, and our fiscal year is opposite the calendar year, we end at the end of June, the state of Georgia, $65 billion as an industry for the state of Georgia. That's second to only agriculture, which is about $80 billion. And that was a year after a worldwide pandemic had shut down the tourism industry. So pre-COVID, we were at about $69 billion. We employ almost 500,000 Georgians across the state in the travel and tourism industry. And what's beautiful about this, and you see it here at LakePoint and in youth sports, is much of the visitor spending, much of the economic impact is generated by people who earn their dollars and are supported in other states, right? They're bringing their money here. Now, granted, we do that too. We go to other states and we spend our tourism dollars. So it is a fair game there. But at the same time, the better job we do there, the better Georgians benefit. You know, I think it's $5 billion in state and local taxes are generated through the tourism industry. It saves every one of our households over $1,000 in taxes that we would otherwise pay if it wasn't for our tourism industry. And it's flat out fun, right? You create memories with your friends and family when you travel around and visit different places and have a good time. And the intersection with sports couldn't be more true.
And certainly here at LakePoint, when you're bringing people from all over the nation here, it's got to help you out on the state economic level for sure, right?
Completely. Yeah.
My last question for you, and then I'll go back to the other Mark. Anything you're looking forward to in the near future for the tourism in the state?
Yeah, you know, I leave here this afternoon to fly to D.C. for a session tomorrow on the future of travel. And I think I heard different elements of it today as on the different panels. I mean, all the panel discussions were fantastic, so thank you to the other speakers. The future the gaming panel blew me away. I have as I mentioned earlier, four children, two boys, an 18-year-old and a 15-year-old. One is an athlete, one is not an athlete, but both are gamers. I don't get it. I'm a 50-year-old guy. I played sports. I enjoy the physical environment, but I understand the power of it. And again, the intersection with travel, right? We're spending a day tomorrow in D.C., peers of mine in other states, meeting with congressional representatives and representatives of industry, transportation industry, technology industries. The CEOs of General Motors and American Airlines are going to be at the event tomorrow, and really kind of looking at what is the future of travel shaping up to be, particularly transportation and technology. How will that impact how people travel? And what I'm looking forward to most is understanding what's happening at a macro level across industries across the country, so we could bring that back to Georgia. So-
Just really grateful and honored that we were able to host such a great group of panelists in this event. You know, before I turn to some of the things we're most excited about, just some of the themes that I heard today. Inflation aside, we talked a lot about accessibility. We talked a lot about the guest experience, and this transcended all the groups. These were just my notes, my observations. We talked about visibility, and what I really liked was not only visibility, but when we had the Celebration of Women's Sports panel, the intentionality around what we're doing around women's sports broadly. And as a father of four daughters, that panel meant the world to me, and just to see us leaning more and more into women's sports and giving women that platform is very exciting, selfishly for me as a father of four daughters, but I think broadly as well, it speaks volumes. I think also just the convergence of traditional sports and modern, what I'll call modern media. And we heard that from our Outside the Lines panel, and I think they did a tremendous job of really providing some fascinating insights of that convergence and the opportunity for us to work together and have all boats rise. And then really, you know, the mental mobility piece, the pressures that are on athletes today, not only on the field or on the court, but just the social media component and the mental mobility for them to navigate all the challenges and pressures that are out there today that weren't there even 5, 10, 15 years ago. So Dr. Lindsay and the work that she's doing in that space, and it's really encouraging to see that there's resources that are coming to the forefront for athletes to navigate this new landscape. And then I mentioned intentionality, and I think that's something that I'm really excited about with LakePoint, is being intentional with our actions and with not only with what we develop from an owned and operated perspective at LakePoint, but some future things that we're working on. So I'll hit a few of them. I believe we've got a couple of slides maybe that highlight some of that. So the first one being, we are in the throes of finalizing, actually it should start in November, is a new hotel. So a new hotel, it's a 114 key element hotel that'll be right across the street from here, led by Horizon Hospitality. So we're looking forward to that. Full service hotel, full restaurant, rooftop bar. So you talk about guest experience, you talk about keeping people on campus and providing them a really exceptional experience. That's something that we're excited about. We talked about—
Talk about tourism. Hotel's the leading driver of the economic impact in the tourism industry.
And it's the number one request we have from our guests on campus, more hotels. So that's exciting, and we're excited to for the Patel family and Horizon Hospitality to really lean in and open up that, start the construction of and open up that hotel in the not-too-distant future. We also, we talked about accessibility. So we're working with the National Council of Youth Sports, and October 24th through the 29th is National Youth Sports Week. And you'll see a full lineup on the screen here of National Youth Sports Week of what's going on there. And we're actually hosting, as the culminating event of National Youth Sports Week, we'll be hosting National Youth Sports Week Play Day, where this campus will be intentionally activated for this event with different sports impacting a cross-section of demographics of youth from across different demographics and psychographics. So we're very excited to offer that. And then lastly, we got to give a plug as the home of the Harlem Globetrotters. We've got the Harlem Globetrotters playing their first international event, I believe, of the next season. Will be hosted December 13th right here at Lake Point, right inside the Champion Center, where we can, I think our seating capacity, the fire marshal allows us about 5,000 seats. So we'll turn this into an arena and a great event for the Harlem Globetrotters. We're hoping they pull off the W and they get a win that night, but you know, we'll have to see how that game goes. But really excited about the growth and momentum at Lake Point Sports. And what I'm truly most excited about is our team members and our commitment to excellence and how we continue to pour in to provide the best experience for our guests and the athletes that visit campus.
I think that was a perfect way to end today, and I know you got him so excited with that hotel, so good thing you announced that today. You guys, thank you for being with us today. There is lunch. Publix lunch is here. I know you guys are hungry. You've been listening to us talk all day, so feel free to stick around, talk to some people, but appreciate you guys. Hopefully you learned a lot today. We heard so many great things as you so beautifully recapped. There were so many amazing panels today, so much good information. So thank you guys for being with us today. Have a beautiful rest of your day, and be safe in the traffic.